We want to determine the factors of 180. The factors are the whole numbers that divide evenly into another whole number. So we want all of the whole numbers that divide evenly into 180. It's also true that if x times y equals 180, and x and y are whole numbers, then x and y are factors of 180. So instead of trying to think of all of the whole numbers that divide evenly into 180, I think it's often easier to use this definition of a factor, but we'll also use the prime factorization of 180 to help us determine all of the factors of 180. So we'll start by making a prime factorization tree for 180. So we can break down 180 as 10 times 18, then 10 breaks down into 2 times 5, which are both prime. We can write 18 as 3 times 6, 3 is prime. And we can write 6 as 2 times 3, which are both prime. So the prime factorization of 180 would be 2 factors of 2, 2 factors of 3, and 1 factor of 5. Now we'll make a multiplication table for 180, and in doing so, we'll determine the factors of 180. So the two most obvious whole numbers that have a product of 180 would be 1 times 180. So these are both factors of 180. And now looking at the prime factorization of 180, we could write 180 as 2 times 2 times 3 times 3 times 5, which would be 2 times, this would be 90, which will give us two more factors of 180. And again, looking at the prime factorization, we can see that 3 would be a factor of 180. So we'd have 3 times, we'd have 2 times 2 times 3 times 5, which would be 60. Again, this gives us two more factors of 180. And again, looking at the prime factorization, we can see that 4 is also a factor of 180, since 2 times 2 is equal to 4. So here we'd have 4 times 3 times 3 times 5. Well, that's going to be 45. So 4 times 45 is equal to 180. Again, which tells us that 4 and 45 are factors of 180. Going back to our prime factors, we can see that 5 would be a factor of 180, and 180 would be equal to 5 times 2 times 2 times 3 times 3, which would be 36. So 5 times 36 is equal to 180. Notice we also have a factor of 2 times 3, which would be 6, and we can write 180 as 6 times 2 times 3 times 5, which would be 30. So we have 6 times 30. And every time we do this, we're finding two more factors of 180. And also notice that I'm trying to do this in order from least to greatest to make sure I don't miss any factors. Notice that 7 and 8 would not be factors of 180, but 9 would be. 3 times 3 would be 9. And we can write 180 as 9 times 2 times 2 times 5, which would be 20. So 9 times 20 equals 180. Notice 10 is also a factor of 180 here and here, and that's actually how we started our prime factorization tree. So we can write 180 as 10 times 18. 11 is not a factor of 180, but 12 is, because here we have 2 times 2 times 3, which is equal to 12, and here we have 3 times 5, which is equal to 15. So we can write 180 as 12 times 15. And now I think we have all of the factors, because notice after 12, the next factor would be 15, which we already have listed here. So here we have a list of all of the factors of 180. The factors are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 9, 10, 12, 15, 18, 20, 30, 36, 45, 60, 90, and 180. So you can see how it was a little extra work to write out the prime factorization of 180, but without this, we could have easily missed some of these factors. So the last step in this type of problem is to write out the factors as a list from least to greatest. So the factors of 180 would be this entire list. I hope you found this helpful.